Yay, Miss Mommy. She's out starting over. That's gonna be good for you too. Who could that be? Let's go see. Who's that? I don't know. Who could it be?
Their mascot might be a real weenie.
Natural toppings galore. When you bite into one, you want some more. We got discounts for groups, for babes and babies. Relish a hot dog top with all the maybes. Come to Man Bites Dog, where you won't get rabies. Come to Man Bites Dog for the best of the hog. What?
What? This is the new job. You're still in show business?
From film professor to pork peddler.
Wow. I love it.
Well, I get to stay inside the mall where it's warm, so...
Well, that's a bonus for February.
Yeah, and I get lots of attention from the little ones, which is always fun. Here, Hope. Have a hand.
Oh, goodness. She's been putting everything in her mouth these days. Oh. I am so sorry for it.
Don't be. It's not that bad.
You got it.
Well, yeah, it is. But humiliation pays, right? You know, I was thinking I might get a movie out of it. I could put a camera in between the bun and the hot dog. You know, a little cinema verite thing.
Okay. Well, while you're making the best of it, can I be hating it for you?
Please do.
So, Clint Buchanan couldn't help you get your teaching job back?
Oh, no way.
Are you sure?
Yeah, that ship sailed. Clint wouldn't lift a finger for me.
You know, Clint just bailed on you.
Well, things got weird between him and my mom. You know, she's the only reason why he helped me and James out in the first place. And that whole thing with Jessica got him pretty upset, too.
Yeah, but how long do you have to be punished for that?
Well, Langston, it was kind of a bad thing.
Well, I know, but still.
You know what? You know what? Forget about Clint. Doesn't matter. Forget about being a giant hot dog. The only thing that matters tonight is the date.
Valentine's Day?
You and me. Oh, don't tell me you changed your mind.
No. This is it tonight. You and me. Trust me. Abstinence has gotten very old.
Oh, glad I'm not the only one. So why won't you kiss me?
Well, I don't know. I feel wrong in front of Hope.
A kiss?
Yeah, well, that and... you're a giant wiener.
You think it'll give her nightmares?
I know. I'll never look at a hot dog the same way again.
Yeah, me neither. Hey. You want to know what kept me going today? You.
You know what kept me going today?
What?
The fact that today's finally here. I have a calendar with a ton of X's on it.
Seriously? You've been counting down the days?
With a big red marker.
Ha! Amateur!
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. 16 hours, 17 minutes, and 10 seconds to go. You know, all day long when someone was making fun of me, I just kept thinking about you and me. Tonight, alone, no buns, well, no plastic relish.
Oh, okay, if it's going to be nothing but hot dog jokes tonight.
No, I'm just kidding. Tonight's going to be perfect.
So why are you pulling nanny detail today? Where's Star?
Right about now, she should be telling your brother that she broke up with Cole.
Seriously?
Yeah, today I went with her to Statesville.
That's a pretty big trip.
Well, she wouldn't end it over the phone.
I'm surprised she ended it at all.
I kind of pushed her a little bit.
A little bit?
Yeah, well, I thought that it was building up for a while. I mean, even before Cole got arrested, things hadn't been good for a long time. But of course, as soon as Cole was in trouble, she was right there by his side, and that's not what he wanted.
Really?
Yeah, Cole tried to break up with her when he went to prison. He doesn't want Star to wait for him.
So you pushed her?
Cole told me to look after Star, so... that's exactly what I did.
So that's why you were pumping me for information about Michelle.
Well, I didn't want my best friend to break up with Cole, only for James to break her heart.
No, it would not happen. James would wait forever for Star. Thank you, Miss Wild.
Oh, for what?
Well, you didn't just help Star. You probably saved my little brother, too.
He looked pretty okay to me.
No, he was a goner. It was pretty pathetic. So, when he and Star didn't hook up at New Year's Eve, I kind of pushed him a little.
Yeah, how?
I told him to hook up with the hottest girl he could find.
Oh, nice.
Hey, Star wasn't giving him any reason to wait. That was the only way to get over it. You want the best for your friend, and I want the best for my little brother.
You are such a dog.
Oh, my God. Really? Yeah.
I have to go get her snack. Can you watch her for a minute?
Okay.
I'll be right back.
Well, what if she cries or something?
She loved you on Christmas Eve. It's gonna be fine.
Well, I had a tree full of shiny bright things to help.
I have faith in you.
Hey, Hope. Hope. Hey. You wanna play handball? Hey. Pass back.
Oh, God.
Drive the plane! We're gonna crash! Pull up! Come on, you're our only hope! Quick! Drive the plane! Pull up! Pull up! Oh, look at Layson's back!
Oh, don't stop! That's the happiest she's been all afternoon!
Really? Is that true?
Yeah, look at her smile!
Well, you can't go wrong with the swing.
You're so good with kids.
Well, they can just tell I'm a bigger kid.
I don't think so. How do you know so much about them?
Well, I used to take care of James a lot.
Yeah, well, I guess you had to with the way your dad was.
I used to build a swing out of Eddie's belt.
How'd that work?
Well, I would, put them together and put him in it like a seat, and then I'd hoist him up over the banister or the porch railing or whatever. And, when he was a kid, I could just pull him right up.
Guess you guys didn't have a real swing set.
Eddie? Spend money on something that was gonna rust anyway? No. Besides, if I had his belts and was using them, then he couldn't use them.
Did that work?
Well, when he was drunk, yeah, but when he was sober, it was a little more difficult. And James was always more scared of him when he was drunk, so I tried to keep him distracted. What?
You like kids.
They're okay. I was at the hospital for a checkup after Jessica had her baby.
You saw her?
Yeah, her and Brody were there with the kid.
Oh, you saw the baby.
Yeah.
I guess it had to happen sooner or later. Was it weird?
Definitely. Kid's cute, though.
Well, you'd have to be with those genes.
I guess.
Hey. What?
I still can't help thinking, what if it had been different? What if that baby had been mine?
What if Jessica's baby had been yours?
What do you mean?
How would you have felt?
I don't know.
Would you want to know the baby?
It doesn't matter. Jessica doesn't want to be anywhere near me, and Brody wants me dead practically. That night was a bad memory for both of us and for different reasons. But still, no matter what, there's no reason why they would want me anywhere around that kid.
Yeah, but it wouldn't be completely up to them.
Doesn't matter. He's not mine. He's Brody's.
Never goes to bed that easy when Star's not here.
Yeah, I think she was just bored. My goodnight moon's a little rusty.
Not at all. She was just exhausted from all the fun she had with you.
Me too. Mm. Let me get my stuff.
Okay. Hey! How'd it go with James?
It went.
Well, I didn't think you'd be back so soon. Well, I know you wanted to start getting ready for your big date. How's Hope? We just put her down for a nap. What about you?
What? Well, aren't you gonna get ready for your big date? James is taking you out for Valentine's Day, right?
James and I are not going out tonight, or ever.
Well, why? What happened?
I was too late.
For what?
He's already with Michelle.
No, that's nothing. They're just friends.
Maybe with benefits. They're sleeping together.
Maybe I wouldn't have sucked as a dad.